Hello all, welcome to Get Into IAS, and in this video we are going to deal with the lesson Ozone Depletion. Under ozone depletion, we are going to see the sources, polar stratospheric clouds in ozone, ozone depletion in Antarctic, ozone depletion in Arctic, environmental effects, and then lastly air quality. So what is a ozone depletion? So what is ozone first of all? So ozone has the chemical formula O3. Oxygen has two atoms and ozone has three atoms of oxygen. So this is the difference between oxygen and ozone. So this ozone is a natural gas present in troposphere and stratosphere. So if this gas is present in stratosphere, it is good. But the same gas, if it is present in troposphere, it is bad because it forms smog. So that is the difference between the ozone in troposphere and stratosphere. This ozone, why it is good in the stratosphere is because it absorbs the harmful UV radiation that is entering inside the Earth's atmosphere. It filters the sun's rays and sends the remaining rays to the surface. So this does not break the O2. That is, the oxygen level in the troposphere will not be broken down because the ozone is taking in all the UV radiations from the sun and sends little amount into the Earth's surface, and thereby it saves the plant and animal life and then acts as a sunscreen. So this ozone depletion, it acts as a sunscreen and then saves the plants and animals or any living being inside the Earth. And then what is ozone depletion? We saw what is an ozone, how it is getting depleted. So the ozone that is destroyed is more than the ozone that is formed. That is, the ozone that is formed is less, but what is destroyed is more. And hence that causes the depletion of ozone. And then what is happening? The decrease of ozone in particular region. That is, the ozone will get depleted in certain region. That is called as ozone depletion. And then mainly in the Antarctic, that is in the South Pole, the ozone got depleted more than 50%. And then now moving into the sources. So what and all are the sources or causes for ozone depletion? The first thing is CFC. This is a very important greenhouse gas. We already dealt with CFC. Let's deal it with detail in ozone depletion. So CFC can be broken down into chlorine, fluorine, and then carbon. So these are the atoms inside CFC. And then where are these CFC used? CFCs are basically used in refrigerants and then aerosol sprays, and then it's also used as a foaming agent. So what does it do? The application of CFC is, it is non-corrosive. You've already heard about CFC, that is, we saw in refrigerants. Instead of CFC, we are using HFC, hydrofluorocarbons, because it is less dangerous than the CFC. So the application of CFC, it is non-corrosive. It does not corrode easily, and then it is non-inflammable, low toxicity, and then it has chemical stability. So these are all the application of CFC, and hence we are using this in the refrigerants or aerosol sprays or foaming agents. And then what is happening is, the lifetime of CFC, we already saw, it is around 40 to 150 years. So it is a huge lifetime. And then what is happening is, this CFC moves from the troposphere to the stratosphere. So there comes the ozone depletion, because the ozone is found in the stratosphere. So how it is happening in the atmosphere, or how it reaches the stratosphere, is the discarded refrigerant. Sometimes we use the refrigerators and discard it. So those discarded refrigerators release the CFC into the atmosphere. So lately what is happening is, that is released into the troposphere. In the troposphere, they are thermally stable, but when they reach the stratosphere, they are not. So what is happening is, from troposphere, they move into the stratosphere, and in the stratosphere, as we already saw, the UV rays are entering in. So what is happening is, after the UV rays have been entered, they release chlorine atoms. So what is happening is the CFC present in the stratosphere will free up the chlorine atoms into the stratosphere. So this is the real danger that is happening in the stratosphere that deplete the ozone, because the chlorine reacts with the ozone and depletes the ozone. So this is what is happening. So what is happening in a chemical formula? Normally, we already saw that the chlorine is being freed from CFC. So this chlorine is being freed. This chlorine will react with the ozone. We already saw the ozone layer, that is O3. And then what will happen is it will form chlorine monoxide. And then lately what is happening is this chlorine monoxide is again reacted with the monoxide, that is a single oxygen, and lately again the chlorine is reformed. Again this process continues step by step, and then oxygen is released in the stratosphere layer. So instead of forming O3, the chlorine is again freed up. So initially we saw the chlorine was freed up from the CFC. Again the chlorine is being freed up. Again this reacts with O3, and again it will be reacting with O3 again and again. So this causes the depletion of ozone layer, because the chlorine is continually reacting with the ozone. And then we have done with CFC, the first source. The second source is nitrogen oxide. The same thing happens with nitrogen oxide. So nitrogen oxides are mostly released from industries and agriculture. So this is destroying the ozone layer again. So let us deal it with the formula. Now this nitric oxide, which is released either from industries or agriculture, reacts with the ozone, and then lately what is happening, it forms nitrogen dioxide and an oxygen molecule. As we already saw here, same way the same reaction is happening here. Nitric oxide reacts with ozone and then forms nitrous dioxide and oxygen. Again, this nitrogen dioxide reacts with a monoxide and then releases nitric oxide and O2. So again, the same process repeats here. So nitric oxide will again get connected with the ozone, and it repeats again and again, and the ozone is being depleted. So this is what is happening with nitrogen oxides. And then lately, next one is the role of polar stratospheric clouds in ozone depletion. We saw the sources that are depleting the ozone. Now there are polar stratospheric clouds, a special term, that is also depleting the ozone. So what are these polar stratospheric clouds? So mainly the types of clouds, that is the polar stratospheric clouds, is divided into three types. So this reaction is very crucial for ozone depletion. So the first thing is nacreous clouds. So this clouds have a length of 10 to 100 kilometers and a quite good thickness. So what is happening is this clouds is otherwise called as mother of pearl clouds, because it irradiates. And then the second type of clouds is it contains nitric acid instead of pure water. So the clouds are formed basically by water vapor, that is pure water. But so this second type of polar clouds has nitric acid instead of pure water. And then the third thing is it is also same as the formation of the first thing. It is same as the nacreous clouds, but the formation is at a slower rate. These clouds form at a faster rate and hence they radiate. That's why it's called as mother of pearl clouds. But this forms at a slower rate and hence they do not shine that much. So these are the three types of clouds inside the polar stratospheric clouds. So we have dealt with the polar stratospheric clouds. Let's move into the ocean depletion in Antarctic region. So we've already seen that the glaciers and ice caps are melting in the Antarctic region. So the ozone is also depleting on the Antarctic as well as the Arctic region, but it is more in the Antarctic region. So the ozone depletion in Antarctic is more when compared to the Arctic region. That is, it is more in the South Pole when compared to the North Pole. This is basically due to the low temperature that is prevailing in the Arctic. That is, when the ozone becomes low, the penetration of the sunlight, that is the ozone has the capacity to take in the UV radiation. So when there is less amount of ozone, the capacity to intake the UV radiation will go down, and then there will be formation of polar stratospheric clouds. We already dealt with the polar stratospheric clouds, that is the three types of clouds. In that, in the Antarctic region, the polar stratospheric clouds will be formed, and then that will destroy the ozone in the Antarctic region. So this is what is the formation. So this is what is the procedure for the destroying of ozone layer in the Antarctic region. So normally what is happening is, in the Antarctic stratosphere, it is much colder when compared to the other region. And then the low temperature over there that is prevailing enables the formation of polar stratospheric clouds, as we saw, below 20 kilometers. So below 20 kilometers, the polar stratospheric clouds will be formed near the surface itself, and hence that will deplete the ozone. And then the next point is, ozone absorbs sunlight. We know very well, O3 absorbs sunlight, and then which causes the increase in temperature in that region. And lately what is happening is that increase in temperature with the altitude in the stratosphere. So if ozone is being depleted in that region, the air becomes cooler. You already know, if ozone is not there, the air in that region will become cooler. And then further adding the favorable condition for the formation of PSC, I mean the polar stratospheric clouds. And then the stabilization of vortex. What is vortex? This vortex is nothing but, so when there is polar stratospheric clouds, lately stabilization of vortex will happen. Vortex is nothing but the vortex is a ring of rapidly circulating air. So a ring will be formed. Inside that ring, there will be a rapid circulation of air, which results in that confines the ozone depletion in the Antarctic region. Lately what happened? We saw there is low temperature and the formation of polar stratospheric clouds that destroys the ozone, and then this gives rise to vortex. That is, vortex is a ring of rapidly circulating air. This is also a cause for depletion of ozone. So this is what is happening in the Antarctic region. And then the next point is, the longevity of the Antarctic vortex, that is the stability or the lifetime of the Antarctic vortex, is another factor enhancing favorable condition for the depletion of ozone. So these are the things happening in Antarctic region. So we've done with the ozone depletion in the Antarctic region, moving to ozone depletion in the Arctic region. So the next thing is, so the ozone depletion has been increasingly evident in Arctic as well. Not alone in Antarctic, even in Arctic, the ozone depletion is favorable. And then the Arctic ozone depletion, which swept across Britain in March 1996, was the greatest depletion of ozone ever recorded in the Northern Hemisphere. So on top of Britain, there was a ozone depletion, that is the thickness of ozone has got down. So this is accounted to be the greatest depletion in the Northern Hemisphere, that occurred in March 1996. And then scientists claim that it had been caused in the past by a dramatic cooling of the upper atmosphere in the Northern Hemisphere. So in the Northern Hemisphere, we already saw the cooling of the atmosphere results to ozone depletion. So these are the causes that happened in the Arctic region. And then now moving to the next thing, how do you measure the ozone? So ozone is measured in three types. Let's look into it. So the ozone measurement instrument and techniques are varied. Some of them are Dobson spectrophotometer and the filter ozonometer. It's otherwise called as MA3. And the last one is the total ozone mapping spectrometer, TOMS. So in the Nimbus 7 satellite. So ozone is measured in three types. First one is the Dobson spectrometer, photometer. Second one is the filter ozonometer called as MA3. And the third one is the TOMS, that is the total ozone mapping spectrometer, measured by the Nimbus 7 satellite. Very important, Nimbus 7 satellite. So these are the three methods in which you can measure the ozone. But the favorable method or the very convenient method used is the Dobson unit, the first one. Moving on to the next topic, what are the environmental effects of the ozone depletion? So we've done with ozone depletion in Arctic and how can you measure the ozone. Now moving to the environmental effects of the depletion of ozone. So what are the environmental effects? So decrease in the quantity of total column ozone, that is the decrease in the thickness, has a huge environmental impact. So what is happening is it will tend to cause increased penetration of solar UV beta radiation. That is when the ozone is not present in the stratospheric region, more amount of UVB radiation enters inside the Earth's atmosphere. And then what is happening is the UVB radiation is most energetic component of the sunlight reaching the Earth's surface. And then it has profound effects on human health, animals, plants, microorganisms, materials, and even on the air quality. And then what are the effects of this ozone depletion in human and the animal health? So potential risk include an increase in the incident of morbidity. That is, there will be more amount of death rate, and then you'll have diseases in your eyes, and you'll have tend to have skin cancer and infectious disease because of the harmful UV radiations. And then these UV radiation have been shown in experimental systems to damage the cornea and the lens of your eyes. So due to the direct sunlight, your eyes is the first thing to get affected. And then experiments in animals show that UV exposure decreases the immune response in the animal system. And then the third thing is people who are having light skin tend to be more affected with skin cancer. So what is the effect of the UV radiation in terrestrial plants? So what is lately happening is the psychological and the development process of the plants are affected by the UV radiation. So normally what is happening is the response of UV beta radiation also varies considerably among species and then also cultivators. So if a cultivator is growing plants in here, these plants tend to have low growth because of the UV radiations. And lately what will happen is these cultivators will tend to grow the plants with UV tolerant materials. And then when this is further consumed by the humans, it will cause various health effects. Next thing is the what are the effects on aquatic ecosystems. So basically the exposure of solar UV radiation has been shown to affect both orientation mechanism and motility in phytoplanktons. These phytoplanktons cannot take in the direct UV radiation and hence they tend to die, and in case the fishes won't have food to feed on. So this is what is happening in the aquatic ecosystem. And then lastly, what are the effects in the air quality? So what is happening to the air quality when the ozone is being depleted? So normally what is happening is the reduction in the stratospheric ozone and the increase in the UV radiation. So the stratospheric ozone is being depleted, right? So there is a reduction and hence a hole is being formed in this area, and the UV radiation entered directly into the Earth's surface without the filter. So the filter is the O3. So normally what is happening is they come inside, they penetrate to the lower atmosphere, resulting in disassociation of key trace gases. So there will be trace gases in the atmosphere down. So these trace gases tend to react with other gases. So this is what is happening, especially methane and other CFCs react at a faster rate or move to the stratosphere at a faster rate because there is no filter in here. And this is what is happening. And then lately, what are the effects on the materials? So the air quality is being affected. And lastly, what are the effects on the materials? There are polymers called as synthetic polymers and man-made polymers. So there are synthetic polymers and the natural polymers. These polymers are very susceptible to the UV radiation, and hence when there is no ozone layer present on the stratosphere, normally it affects the synthetic polymers or the natural polymers. So this is what is the effects on the materials. So under ozone depletion, we saw the sources that cause the ozone to deplete. We saw about the polar stratospheric clouds, that is the three types of clouds. And then we saw the ozone depletion in Antarctic, ozone depletion in Arctic, and the environmental effects. And lastly, we saw the air quality because of ozone depletion. So we've done with the ozone depletion lesson. Thank you for watching.